streamed, live streamed. Oh boy. So I could turn the radio up a little bit, but I wanted to know, if you haven't been here before, why are you here today? To what do we owe the honor, pleasure, and intense reason for gratitude for your presence with us in this virtual space today? Feel free to unmute yourself if you have that ability.
Bob, what was the question? The question was, why are we here?
If you've never, yeah, if this is your first burn, why are you here at this burn? How did you come? Oh, thank you. How did you come to this burn? 2021, the great unknown. How did you find out about Sparkleverse? Have you invited some friends?
Oh, it looks
or
like.
What are you expecting?
Burning Koipu. Looks like I want to hear what you have to say.
Hey, hello everyone. I attended the virtual burn last year through Sparkleverse, had a fantastic time, had a great time connecting at a couple of the events through the year, living in London, and various kind of boring work reasons. I never made it physically across to a burn before. I think it may be hard to do that in the future, but this is a way that I can be involved, I can take part, and I can meet some of you wonderful people through the magic of the internet.
You've got one at a time. I'll hold my hand up. Here we go. All right. Thank you, Bubbly Sparkle Fairy. So, Burning Koipu, I see in your reflection of your glasses a ring light, which gives me this story about you that you record online often. Do you have a thing you're offering to the playa? Anything you're going to gift, or how are you going to show up?
I do. Last year, I was just watching and seeing what was going on. This year, I'm doing some improvised soundscape music, kind of meditative music. I've literally just finished a 30-minute kind of meditation soundscape. To be honest, I do a lot of Zoom filming for work, so that the ring light is a work thing, but it was perfect for this as well.
Well, what camp are you in? What are you going to be? How can people who are in here now, how can they find you? When is your event or events?
I'm doing things. So right now in the UK, it's 8:30 in the evening. I'm doing 8 p.m. So half an hour before this every evening. I am, it's called Strange Loop Studios. It's a pop-up event. And I'm having some conversations about maybe getting in with a camp as well. But for now, Strange Loop Studios.
Alrighty, we can search when you get on the playa. You can search for that. Thank you so much.
Thank you.
Anybody else?
It was so lovely to meet you. So everybody, welcome, welcome, welcome. We are here at Gate Road. And today I would love for all of you to, if you could, we have a virtual background in the chat, and you can let us know that you are officially here at Gate Road by changing your background to this amazing Gate Road background. Fantastic.
Your first gift you received, and you haven't even gone through the gate. Welcome home.
Ooh, welcome home, everybody. Welcome home. And for those of you who have not been here before, we do have a little ritual here at Burning Man where we need to dust ourselves with the playa dust and make a couple of dust angels. So normally this happens for virgins, but today we're all virgins because we're all entering into this new amazing universe called the Sparkleverse. And so today we are all going to bless ourselves with sparkle playa dust. So first step number one, you all have 2 minutes to go into your pantries and get either baby powder, flour, quinoa, rice, salt, pepper, anything that is your dust. You'll get it, bring it on back, and we're gonna dust ourselves. So I'm gonna start the timer. Bobcat, maybe we can like amp up music and we can give people 2 minutes to go do this?
I can do that. I need to go get my, oh, I have actual playa dust in my bathroom. I'm actually going to put real playa dust on. All right, everybody, let me change the music. Sorry for putting you to sleep. Here we go. Let's fix this.
Not at all. I think I can also do something as well if you wanted to go get your playa dust, because I am.
No, I got it. It's very close. Here we go. Everybody knows that I love this song. I'm going to turn it up a little louder. Does that sound good?
Let's do it. And I'll tell you all when to go. And go! Go! 2 minutes out! 2 minutes out! Go, 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 go! Dancing on the people, roll the baffy after joint, dancing on the people, people dancing on the people. I got people on the people, people dancing on the people with the people on the people, smoking CO2. See me, see you dancing on the people, climb up on the booth, hanging from the people on the people. My head hits the roof, dancing on the ceiling on the people. I got people on the people, dancing on the people. I got purple hat, cheetah print, dancing on the people, roll the baffy after joint, dancing on the people, people dancing on the people. I got people on the people, people dancing on the people with the people on the people, smoking CO2. See you dance on the people, climb up on the booth, hanging from the people on the people, dancing on the ceiling on the people. I got people on the dancing on the people. I got people. All right, everybody, it's time. It's time. I hope you all are ready for this. I would encourage everybody to go into gallery mode. That's what I would love to encourage everyone to do. So go on into the top right, click on view, click on gallery. Let's take a look at everybody in this beautiful, beautiful room today. Welcome all of our new friends. We have an Emerald Hook and a Bunny Ears and a Zuro and Hesse of Astonish and Taina and K-Bot. And we even have a Brenda and a Trevor and a Kevin and a Pierre and a Victoria and an Ermia and a James. Wow, everybody, welcome, welcome. And Jay, welcome everyone. So I think before we spray ourselves in our playa dust, we all just need to think of an intention. What do we want to bring to this burn? Think about it in your head. Think about the type of person that you want to be. Who you want to bring to this burn, who you want to affect with this burn, and what kind of energy you want to spread at this burn. And now, release your playa dust. I want you to put it in your hands and feel it. Ooh, feel that goodness. Roll it around in your hands.
Actual playa dust, actual, yeah, inside and out. Oh.
Mine is a little bit of baby food, but it totally works. And all you're gonna do is gonna be really fun. You're just gonna put it on your face. Put it on my face.
Get it in your face. Oh my God. This is crazy. There's playa dust everywhere. It's all over my vintage t-shirt.
All over.
See people on gallery view. Where is everyone on gallery view? Removing the spotlights. We should all be
everybody
seeing each
dust
other.
Angel. Everyone dust angel.
Dust Angel, Dust Angel. Yes. Give it to the beat. A little like Dust Angel aerobics. Bobcat, can we turn it up a little bit? Get the party
you
started.
You got it. It's going to come here. Wait for it. Not too long.
Everybody, you look amazing. Absolutely amazing. Okay, so it looks like we've got 20 more minutes. I would love to do like one epic dance right now with our dust, and then maybe we can all present our gifts to the client. Right? Let's do this. Let's finish all this one set, y'all. Yeah. Going to get everybody.
If there's no dust storm, we can be the dust storm. I feel like I need a lighter to make a flame.
Oh, God.
Look how beautiful you all are.
Yeah.
Oh my God, look at that beautiful. Whoa.
Mirrorception. Oh my God, making everybody a cat back then.
What the hell time is it? It's now, it's time for get your asses in the air.
Right now.
We're in
right
your now. Chair. Get your asses in your chair if you need to.
Oh my God, Bobcat, is that hat your gift to the playa?
No, I've got a better one. It's a little adult theme. This is an 18 and only party this time, okay? But it's a little bit adult. I'll show you my playa party.
Whoa. Yes.
Okay. I am bringing peace, tranquility, balance. I am bringing the qualities of humor, of enjoyment of good food and wine. I am bringing classically trained. I am also bringing some Hoochie Mama Mac Daddy sex, okay? So what is he thinking about? Look at that. Oh my God, get it on. Now there will be an orgy dome, I hear. I don't know where it is. I don't know when things are happening, but I will tell you that there's gonna be this and there's gonna be this.
Oh yeah, there is. Yeah, there is. I'd like to present my playa gift, which is this pink boa. And this boa, Bobcat, can we turn down the music just like a little slightly?
Of course.
Thank you so much. Still in the background though. So this is actually a gift from somebody else that I know. And now I'm presenting it to the playa for fun and engagement and just bringing out the parts of yourself that maybe in the default world you feel like you cannot express. Bring that to the playa, share it with the world, and make it rain with good vibes.
You want to radically express yourself in the present moment, gifting who you are to other people, making a communal effort, oh boy, to decommodify your connection with real humans through this electronic computer screen, but real connection with real humans, Bobcats. So before we get going, I know we've been on the road a long time. It's about 900 miles for me to get to the playa from Colorado. I brought some coconut oil and sea salt sheet tortilla chips if you guys want some. So just grab out and get a little bite there, because you can get dehydrated out here and hyponatremic if you don't get enough salt. So just pass that along. Get your hand out. Okay, K-Bot, thank you. Block Art in Peru, hello. Make sure you get enough there. I also have these things, which I call crack sticks. Maybe, I think Jess might even know these, but anyway, they're amazing. So just keep your water bottle full too.
Yes, definitely always hydrate. So I'd love to know what everybody else brought as their ticket to get into the playa. So if you would like to share, I'd love for you to just hold it up to the screen and we'll see. K-Bot, what do you have here for the playa?
Ooh, unmute.
This is a wolf. And the reason why I'm bringing a wolf to the playa is because I feel that the ritual burn is a wild and wily and playful place. There's nothing quite like a wolf howling to go, "Ow!" You know that you're gonna have some wild times and some interesting experiences that we can't necessarily easily harness.
Who is this floating head next to you? Is that an art piece too? Is that an art piece?
I see floating head.
Floating head.
I don't know. He's head? Only a head. There's just a head. I don't know.
Well, he knows speak? How to get a head.
Do you speak?
Hi, everybody. I'm known in logistics. Dom.
And I mean,
cool.
I appreciate that. Thank you guys for bringing your wolf wildly cells to the playa. Hopefully there'll be a full moon at some point for you to howl at. So it looks like we do have another person who might have a gift for the playa, Miss Snacks, looking so good in those goggles.
thanks.
I want to take
thanks.
A bite of her snacks. Where is she? Let's put her up.
Oh, my.
There we go.
Oh, my.
Are they salty or sweet?
Well, I got some melon right now. So, you know, melon on the playa is a super important thing, especially when you're just like out there for so long. My baking soda dust is really sticking too. But my gift is this little guardian angel, you know, ooh, like you got to have your guardian angel out there that can watch over you and all your people. I'm also gifting some twerk lessons this week. So I'm excited.
Wow. Would you? So I like to buy a car after I take a test drive. Can we see a test drive of your twerk just to show so we know that you're talking, you know what you're talking about? How do we know what you're twerking about?
Are you okay with everybody being on Facebook and YouTube?
Yeah.
Ooh.
Definitely.
So I will just say this is a good opportunity for everybody to listen about consent, okay? We're not just going to make her do it. She has every right all along the way to have an enthusiastic yes. And if it isn't enthusiastic, we don't care. We'd like, okay, cool. Maybe other gifts another time. If you feel like it, it's all good. So apparently we're in luck today and we get to see Snack's preview of her twerk shop.
Well, yeah. I have to say, the big thing about it though, is I have so much respect for all the twerkers that have
alive.
And so this thing for me, and the reason I'm teaching this is because I think that all of us just need to get into our sacral. So this is one move of three that you will learn.
Oh my God. Okay, all wait, right? let's remove all spotlights and then big? Spotlight her.
You're gonna spotlight
her. Oh, yeah. Yeah, we wanna make sure you're spot lit. Where is she?
All right.
I lost her. Okay, I got it.
Right here. But I'm out. All right. Okay, ready? You ready?
Yeah.
Pretty quick. Mm-hmm.
All right. Good. What? Oh my God. What? I had a feeling about you, but I had no idea. Oh my God.
You'll learn it if you come.
Okay.
It's like, what is it? 8 p.m. tomorrow on Monday or 10 a.m. on Wednesday. So I'll teach all of you to shake like that.
Look, and Matt, where can we find you? I know you just said the time, but what camp are you going to be in?
Co-reality.
Ooh, Co-reality. I heard they got some good stuff going on over there.
Yeah.
Wow.
Dude, just thinking about being there and seeing more of that, I go from a bobcat. Ooh, let's see. Spotlight my dumbass. Just thinking about that, I go from this cute little petty kitty to a... Okay, all right, it's out of my system. Back to reality.
Okay. Fantastic. Reality. Okay, who else has a gift for Ziplaya?
Raise your real life hand or tentacle or... Okay, ooh, over there, let's see. Mr. Someone whose name is a little challenging for me to pronounce. How are you, sir?
Hey, good. It's Ride for Life. And I ride motorcycles, but I brought a very tiny guitar.
Oh, and, so cute.
And hopefully I can just bring a little music and flame.
Oh, what? It's a lighter and a light?
God, it's a lady guitar. Wow, where did you get this from, Michael?
Where do you get these? The same place everybody gets them, at the liquor store.
Yeah.
So, anyway, I'm just a first-time visitor here, so thank you.
Oh, welcome, welcome, Virgin. Welcome, welcome. Have you dusted yourself off in any playa dust yet?
Not officially this year, but in past years, yes.
Oh, I thought you said this was your first time. No, you've been to Burning Man.
First time in the Sparkleverse.
Okay. All right.
Well, welcome home.
How are you in the process of saying, you know what, how could it possibly be as cool? How could I have as much fun sitting in front of my computer? I do that every day. Like, what was it that you heard about it? What was it that you read about it that has us blessed with your presence here today?
I just wanted to experience the same thing everybody else does, which is, togetherness with people, and hopefully this is a place to do that and share the love.
That's the place. Ride for life. I really, really want to get a motorcycle. I'm thinking about getting an electric one. But when I do, you look for Bobcat or you just hunt me down. You'll find me. People know me. And I'd love to ride
if I see a Bobcat on a motorcycle, I'm going to know who it is.
All right. Well, look, high five here. And I make a promise that if we can connect up in real life, I will ride my electric motorcycle with you. Anybody else want to come? You put your hand up on that screen. Let me take all these spotlights off again.
All right. Go into gallery mode. Put your hands up for the...
Yeah, thank you. Gallery mode. This is real. We're in this place together. Our bodies are all over the planet, but our souls, our being, our awareness, our intention, our ability to manifest the reality we want is in here in this weird Zoom room. It's ones and zeros, and it's everything, man. So welcome. Welcome home.
Welcome home. So I saw a couple other people have things for the playa. Koji, I think you had your hand up. Did you? Do you have something that you want to give to the playa?
Yes. Thank you very much. I brought a little bit of luck, my lucky kitten, for the multitude and the randomness of meeting new people, making new connections. So a little bit of luck just to explore what's out there and to experience new connections with people. Authentic.
Yes. Thank authentic you. Connections. Authentic connections. I love that you got the playa dust on you. Is this the first time that you've been to Burning Man?
Yes. I've always wanted to go. Never had the opportunity. And then seeing the Sparkleverse. It's the amazing connection between people. It's the artwork, it's the installations, it's the music, it's the vibe, it's the letting go of who I thought I was and emerging into who I choose to be. So I'm really excited to be here and just really excited to see all these wonderful people joining with us.
Yes, all the love, Koji, all the love. Thank you for being here.
I heard, Koji, that we all take turns cooking dinner for camp, and I heard you're gonna take Wednesday night. So would you mind telling us the special treat you've prepared for us? I think it's a recipe from one of the planets on those posters behind you. If you're willing to give us a hint of what you're gonna cook for the camp, that's exciting. Wink, wink.
Wink, wink. Well, first, I didn't know if there's any kind of food allergies, interspatial, cuisines, you know, can be effective to the dietary system. So are there any allergies out there tonight?
No, but I am a vegetarian.
Ah, veggie. Ah, so a little bit of chopped salad from the forest moons of Hoth. You know, slight, a little bit of dressing. Balsamic vinegar, just from the Tatooine Palace. It's absolutely phenomenal. A little drizzling goes a long way.
I don't eat cat myself, but I think wampa is something I could go for. Can I tell a Hoth joke and then maybe someone else has something to share? I'm so happy to see you, Koji.
Pleasure.
What temperature is the inside of a tauntaun? That would be lukewarm. Do y'all remember that?
Very nice.
Yeah, pretty good, right? All righty. Who wants to say something? I feel people on the edge of their seats to share because we do have a few minutes left until the main ceremony. Take it away, Bubbly Sparkle Food.
I was just imitating people who wanted to speak. I just felt it. I just felt like that. I know you want to say something. So, it looks like we have a Pamela in the house. We got a Metamon. We got an Oscar. We got a Sarah, we got a Golden Boy, we got a Peach. Man, we got everybody in the house today.
Hell yeah.
All right, so we looks like we have time maybe for one more person to offer something. So does anybody have anything that they just, you know, would love to provide to the playa to start off this beautiful journey?
Looks like Block Ooh. Art Peru.
Oh.
Let's spotlight our friend in Peru.
America's president. Oh, yes. Well, I'm Brenda, also known as Block, also known as Otoronga, by Russians, like the puma from the jungle, or, well, as a legion of art. And today my gift would be kinkiness, kinkiness with kinkiness. So get ready, because we are coming with the Latino power
our camp.
Thank you. Oh my gosh, I am so excited for that. We need kink. We need kink on the playa. It's time. Oh yeah, I mean, Bobcat, like, if that's you bringing the kink, that's what I want to see.
I'm just saying.
Favorite video.
People come to these parties and they're like, oh my God, I just need human connection. Like, how am I supposed to like, you know, feel sexy or flirt with people? Well, you got to just take, wait, here he is. A little bit of Patrick Swayze's moves. That's it. Even Chris Farley will be a complete raging orgy dome hero if you learn from Patrick Swayze. Okay, everybody, maybe we try to do some of these moves.
Let's do it. Everybody, please go into gallery mode. We are going into gallery mode. And Bobcat, right. show us how to do some of these moves, baby. Maybe we all take
a stand. Hold up, let's see. All right, so we put our hands on our hips and we shake them around. Okay, we got a twist, a jump, don't hit anything. All right, now flex your pelvis. Nobody's actually looking at you. It's okay, just do it. No one's looking at your screen. There's like 100 of them. Okay, all right, come on.
Maybe Bobcat, let's turn up the music a little bit. Have a 1 minute dance party, shall we?
Let's do that. Turn your speakers up.
It's Burning Man. No.
Yes. How are they ever going to let you into the dome if you don't practice your move? Actually, they're radically inclusive. Oh my God.
I feel like the gates are about to open. It's about to happen. They're about to open. You ready for this? Are we all ready to go to Burning Man?
We're ready.
Yeah. Huh. Woo. Hell yeah. Let's do this.
I think we have someone who's going to open the gate for us. Maybe. Is that a Juicy Peach who's doing this?
Ooh.
Juicy Peach opening a gate for us?
It could quite possibly be.
Where is she? Where is she? Show us the peach.
I need more enthusiasm from you all. I need a drum roll, please.
You unmute yourself and go, peach, light. Peach, 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 peach,
peach, peach, peach, light a flame. Peach, 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 light a flame. Show some sparkle, light that peach. Get her going. Oh, I think I see her. Oh my God, she's way above the playa. Where
hello,
did she come?
Hello. Oh gosh, hello. Yes, welcome. As you can see, we're getting there. We're opening the gates. But to really open the gates, I think we need a little bit of a... Can you provide this? I want you to put your hands up in the air, straight above you, down to the sides. Don't knock over any drinks. Down to your sides. But back up to 90 degrees, up to the top. All together now, up to the top, out to the sides, down. And out to the sides and up.
YMCA, it's fun
and
to
now,
stay
smoother,
at the...
Smoother.
YMCA, fun to stay at the YMCA, fun to stay... Every, you can hang out with all the boys.
And there they are. They're open.
Okay.
Woo!
The gates have opened. Let's get in there.
We don't have a camera.
Alrighty, we have a fantastic introduction for you from the one, the only, the most fantastical Captain A.
Hello, everybody. Welcome to Sparkleverse. Enormously warm welcome. It's an absolute pleasure to see you entering the Sparkleverse.
Why don't you put it there so I can sit down too? Yeah.
Say that one more time.
Don't worry, darling. We just need to mute people.
Okay, it's good. Anyway, so huge welcome. And I'm going to tell you a little bit about how Sparkleverse came to be, because perhaps not it right can inform your adventures a little bit. And so... back in the UK at the outset of the pandemic, a group of us sort of came together from across kind of California and London and other places where we had friends, because one thing was extremely clear to us, which is that if we were going to spend a year in lockdown in the pandemic, it was vitally important that we don't stop celebrating. We think of parties as the ultimate kind of engines of human consciousness. And it was clear to us that you know, even though we were going to be stuck in our flats, the one thing which had to carry on was human festivity together. And it was that commitment that kind of led to a series of parties with the Co-Reality Collective. And at these parties, one of our early discoveries was that although these parties were virtual, they were real. They involve real people and real places and real consciousness and real friendships happening and real discoveries of new ideas, new concepts, new ways of experiencing and being. And so we kind of realized that, like, although kind of online, you often talk about it as being virtual, but we kind of came to realize it was actually just spatially decentralized. And then when, as a result of those first 10 parties, we wound up having the incredible honor of supporting Burning Man going online. We don't use the term sort of lightly, the honor it is, because, you know, Burning Man is arguably the greatest institution and certainly the most magnificent engine of consciousness ever conceived. And it's worth pausing a little while to think about how Burning Man functions on our consciousness. And so, you know, when we go to Burning Man, it's not just like an isolated set of inputs. It's a whole immersive participatory adventure. It begins many months out. There's an enormous road trip. There's tremendous struggle and adversity, even in just getting to the place. And, you know, gradually we become more and more and more removed from the banalities of our everyday consciousness. You know, if we wanted to get on work Slack, A, we'd be too far away to do anything about it, and B, you know, we're away from the internet. And so gradually the oppression of everyday consciousness gets left behind, and one enters this extraordinary space of creativity where everything is ephemeral, everything is transient. It's a pure gift between human beings looking to enchant each other's consciousness. And what else, you know, are we here to do on this planet other than enchant each other's consciousnesses? So that's kind of something of like how Burning Man functions, this kind of separation from the everyday and entering a kind of zone of enchantment. And so, huge honor to be able to interpret and try to bring Burning Man into a recognizable, spatially decentralized fashion. And there were many magic moments last year, but some of the most extraordinary, which we really recognized, were when one bounced between different places on Earth where one met wildly different communities and people. One would be in a dance party in South America, and then one would click through, and then there would be three Indian ladies playing sitars. And then one would go into some sort of West Coast philosophy discussion about the nature of consciousness. And one would sort of bounce through these spaces, and it kind of revealed that, like, the spatially decentralized version of Burning Man, represented this year by six universes, Sparkleverse included, has a special quality of magic. A special quality, if one looks through the principles of Burning Man, of inclusion. It's possible for people with alternative bodies and ideas and geographies and finances to participate and enjoy especially decentralized burn in a way that the one in Nevada doesn't quite as much invite. And so that's kind of how we've been thinking about this year's Sparkleverse. We've really become enchanted with the possibility of including as wide a variety and as people, ideas, consciousness as possible. We've been very hard at work on this. We have a wonderful team we met in St. Petersburg, who informed us with great seriousness that it would be an honor to work on Burned Out Man. And we've been working with them to help create the Sparkleverse. As ever, it's a Sunday night of the burn. Nothing's quite constructed. You'll see all sorts of magic flowing into the platform over the next 6 days. But of course, this is not about the Sparkleverse. It's not about the platform. It's about all of the creativity and connection and friendships and consciousness that you're able to enact and bring and share with each other. On that simple note, an enormously warm welcome and have a glorious, mind-expanding, connective and inclusive time at the Sparkleverse.
Yeah, Captain.
Yeah.
Right, now what are we supposed to do?
Amazing. I'm hoping to get the delightful Iona.
Hello, everybody. Don't mind me. I'm just washing before we start the burn. I know I'm going to be dirty all week, so I'm just going to have one final clean. Well, welcome, everybody. I'm going to kind of give you a little rundown of what's going on this week. But obviously, there's still more to be built. So I'm only telling you what's currently on the plier. I'm sure some of you might have more things to come, but I'm just going to talk to you, and then afterwards the lovely Peach Melba is going to actually give us a tour. So this is just a speaking thing, like it's sort of a memory test. Think of all the things you can possibly say. So when you actually get on the plier, you do have a schedule you can look at. You have a search bar to search for events and camps. You have the chat, and people will be posting in the chat, like, check out this thing. So always keep your eyes on that. We've got daily emails, like with the highlights of the day. And and you can obviously go around the plier and move your little avatar around to like check out all the camps. So there's quite a lot of ways you can find out what's going on. But also, I'm just going to give you a little rundown. So what I suggest is you familiarize yourself with the plier. In the center, we've got plier info. We've got, and you can go and meet all the wonderful volunteers who are here helping you with information. We've got the rangers, and if you've got any needs, you go and speak to them. They're a beautiful bunch of people. And we've got costume shops, so if you want to get fun with some like funny virtual backgrounds and snap cameras, go and head on there. There's loads going on, and it's day one, so you know we need to travel there, right? So head on to go on a road trip, and you can drive onto the burn. That's one of the best things about the burn, is the journey there. Just having a chat with your fellow burners about what's in store for you. It's a really fun camp. Obviously now we're at the opening ceremony, so welcome everybody to Sparkleverse. We're going to do, there's going to be typical things that are at Burning Man, and all the burner camps that are usually at Burning Man are actually going to be at Sparkleverse, and they include talk to God. So you talk to God. You can talk to God 24/7 all week long. So go and check out Talk to God, our piece on the plier. We've got Pink Heart. We've got Urban Plier. We've got Corporation Chaos. They are epic. Love them loads. And they've got a philosophy booth, so you can ask them any questions. We've got the Lost Penguins. We've obviously got the Temple. So loads of stuff that, you know, for me, same at Burning Man, they've come to the virtual burn. So thanks for coming. We've also got Co-Reality Collective, it's what kickstarted this whole online party phenomenon. So we've got load going on all week. So if you can't find anyone on the plier, there's usually someone in Camp Co-Reality. And if you want to get involved, maybe you can just put yourself on the schedule of Camp Co-Reality. We've got loads of stuff on Zoom. It's very interactive. And we've also got a soundstage. So loads of cool stuff. Okay, we've got fire. We've got the fire ceremony live streaming from Fire Conclave. We've got the man burn, we've got art, we've got flow state, we've got flat earth art, we've got Van Gogh yourself, or is it Van Gogh? I don't know if it's Van Gogh or Van Gogh, where he will draw you. We've got burner girls, we've got all sorts of art. We've got huge, what is so exciting about a virtual burn is that we have art collectives from around the world. We've truly gone global. Okay, we have from Greece, we have Dire Wolf. We have Afro Psychedelic, this amazing Nigerian camp with stuff all through the week with loads of amazing performers. We've got the Block Art Collective from Peru. I see Brenda's on the line, is on the Zoom, and she's gonna talk to us about that later. We've got artists from Antarctica. We've got some Korean artists. We've got an oracle reader all the way from Japan. We've got a comedy night from Vietnam, and we also have Camp Languages. I don't know if Avishta and Richard are on the Zoom call. If you are, then they're going to tell us about Camp Languages. You can do some language exchanges. They've got like salsa classes and bachata and like you're going to learn how to say beer and love in loads of different languages. Loads of cool stuff. Gosh, I've got so much to say. I'm going to have to speed up, aren't I? So we've got dance. We've got loads of dancing. We've got DJs. We've got Twerking by Snacks. We've got Pop Up Boogie by myself. I'm going to do actually Madonna Hour, Backstreet Boys Hour, Britney Hour. I'm going to do all the music. We've got the Doge Disco. Oh, yes, we have. We've got the DDP, which is the Decentralized Dance Party, the famous ones. They are going to take over. We've got Ecstatic Dance Camp every single night of the week, or night in my country, but whenever your country. Right, we've got Days Discotheque. We've got Altered States of Independence from Brixton. We've got the Hot Tub Player Party. Do not miss the Hot Tub Player Party. That is going to be epic. We've got Base Coast. We've got loads of Twitch streamers all around a radio station. So there's always going to be music the whole time. Okay, we've got fitness. We've got Camp Kaya, who are going to be doing so much fitness. It's going to be absolutely epic. If you want to get fit, this Kaya lady, she's not called Kaya, but she's a guru. You know, it's not just fitness, it's meditation. Your life will be transformed. So check out that. We've got Ho Yoga, which is yoga for hoes. Right, okay, moving on. We've got random stuff. Like we've got Banana Camp. If you like bananas, you want to celebrate bananas, come to Banana Camp. We've got Camp Dave. If you're called Dave, or you've got friends called Dave, or you just like the name Dave, you might call your child Dave, go to Dave Camp. We've got Hide and Seek in the 3D space camp, so you can just go and play hide and seek, and that'll be super fun. We've got activities. We've got the Knitwits that are going to be knitting an afternoon tea with our lovely Isabel. She will be knitting with you. We've got an improv comedy jam. We've got an open night mic night if you want to maybe take to the stage. And we have writer's hour four times a day. So if you just fancy writing for an hour in silence, but with a bunch of people, go to writer's hour. That is going to be epic. Right, and what else have we got? It is a burn. We've got a sex positive camp, and they are doing something sexy on a Tuesday. So if you want to get naked and connect people physically, then go and check that out with Mr. Marshmallow. What else have we got? We've got the World Storytelling Camp. So you go out there to hear stories and check out stories. And we've got, okay, one of my favorite camps, you really have to check out this, is Spirit Space. They have loads and loads and loads of stuff going on all week long, loads of spiritual stuff and meditation and like how to have more joy in your life. We've got the Shamanic Shaman University, Whirling Rainbow Camp, which is going to be amazing. And we've got, also, we've got breath workshop. We've got Thank You Plant Medicine. They're all about sharing circles to talk about our psychedelic experiences. And they have sharing circles for different people, like so BIPOC and LGBTQ and women's circles and stuff like that. We've got Discover Your Superpower. Oh my gosh, we've got so much. We've got tarot card reading and comedy nights and all sorts. But anyway, I am going to stop talking because I've talked for far too long. But basically, we've got a lot going on. It's going to be exciting. And there's more to come because more people are going to co-create, and we might have spontaneous things happen during the week too. So I'm going to pass you over to Peach Melba, who's now going to give you a tour of the Playa. Okay, that's all for me.
Thank you, Iona. We so appreciate you. I can't wait to check out all of that amazing, amazing, amazing content. So, Peach, let us know. How
do we use the Sparkleverse? Well, you're going to learn. Everything's going to be absolutely bloody fantastic. Right. So,
we'll start by stopping that and getting on to the pyre itself. Now, many of you will have seen something similar to this, and we're going to teach you how to use it. So there's many places you can go, there's many places you can be, but you are exactly where you need to be right now. We have up here our navigation of our schedule. Can I get a whoop whoop for the schedule? Whoop whoop whoop. This is a place where you can see everything that is on, that is to come, and will come in a few days. And what you can do is all open up this page right now. Just minimize your Zooms, get on the plier, and I want to see people opening up this What's On tab. Ooh, what is it? What is it? It's on. Fantastic. And what you're going to do is you're going to scroll through here, and I want you to find something on one of the days that takes your fancy, and I want you to click this little button here, because that will solidify that event in your memory, in your heart, in your soul. And what you can do then is click on this little tab up here, the bookmarked events, and it will just filter out all of the events your heart truly desires. All righty. What we have up here is our announcements panel. The announcement panel is very, 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 very important, because everybody who is anybody in the control center over here at Sparkleverse HQ is controlling what goes on to here. So if it says something, it means it's important. And what we can see is we've got all of these people zooming on all over the place. Oh, I see there's ad hoc down there. Oh, I'm gonna use my arrow keys or the WASD and go over to ad hoc here. And if I click on them, you see that you can send them a message. And we can say, hi, hi ad hoc. I hope your visit to the virtual burn is proving successful, smiley face. And if you really want, oh look, ad hoc says hello. You can also send emojis. Fantastic. So let's zip it up. This is so exciting. And you'll notice that in chatting with our darling friend ad hoc there, we've opened this panel up here. So we have our direct messages, but we also have party chat. Oh yes, party chat is where everybody can leave their mark by saying things like, how are you? Or love you, Sophie, whoever that is. And Hopealicious here. Hello, Hope. Hello, hello, hello. And yes, what you can also do is click on this little thing here, which gives you some extra powers to create polls. Like, should I drink water? Yes, and definitely.
Yes.
Because yes. Hydration is extremely important. Send your poll and get back to your life. Ah, hello, Koji. You can also, these functions, not quite specific to whatever you guys are doing, but it's good to know about everything anyway. So you can ask a question, why? And it'll highlight that if you want a little extra zhuzh. Maybe you want to, you have an event starting very soon and you wish to, I don't know, tell people about it. You can highlight it with that little function. And if you're feeling lost, if you're feeling dusty, well, visit our help center. Our help center is here to make sure that you have the best time ever. You can speak to Sparkle Help, that's us guys. You can also speak to the dedicated vest rangers who are there to kind of help. Look with out. Any.
This is the Burning Man.
Yes. Or you can head on over to Playa Info, where you can have lots of information about lots of things. Let's get a thumbs up for lots of things. Yes. Excellent. What else do we have? Well, along the top bar here, we have our simplified view, which is a listing of all of what's going on and where, without the clutter, the hustle, or the bustle of the immersive view of the Playa. So here you can see what's going on live and how many people are in each space. So that, for me, is extremely exciting. And you can also access the schedule here. So if you are not wanting to navigate the Playa, then this little space is for you. And that opens itself up into a new tab so that you can see it. But our wonderfully immersive Playa is just underneath. You can also use our search bar. If there's something specific, like I want Doge, you can find yourself all of the camps, the people, and the events. And maybe you will find something that you did not expect. Onwards, upwards, we have our atmosphere toggle. If you want to feel like you're in the genuine Playa, there's a little bit of background music for you there. And if you want to change your profile, you can. You can change your picture, you can update your name, and all is hunky dory. Bum, 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 bum. And there's a little hamburger message here that you can like visit some very useful websites. Woo! Okay, the last thing I want to show you is a few little bits on the map here. So we have all of these portals here which take you to various different places. And you can go explore. We have camps, we have art pieces, we have links to external experiences. And all of them are available to you. Yes, yes, yes. Star, did you want to, were you putting, you're just whooping, nothing. That's all. Okay, right, so when you are me, who is Snoop Dogg, you can zoom with these different controls here. So you've got walking mode, which really puts you in the center of things. You have bike mode, which zooms you out a little. And then you have bird's eye view to give you a big overview of the Playa. Down here, we have shout outs. So you can say, hey, I'm so excited. And we can send that and it pushes it out to the Playa. Oh, peachy. Very nice, thank you, SP. And you can always click on the center point because you can actually move your mouse around if you're wanting to explore maybe towards the trash vents, and you can recenter yourself like so. And you'll also notice the very final thing I want to show you is burn barrels. So say we double click on this guy, you'll notice along the bottom, cameras, people, Captain Cook, unmuted with a beautiful feedback loop, because usually wouldn't be also in a Zoom room. Yeah, so you can have these impromptu on the Playa interactions and have a lovely time. And then you can click our little leave button, which will kick you out of there. Impromptu. What else can I show you whilst I'm here? Let's go into an art piece. So this is another area where you can get your little face out and you can potentially interact with stuff. So this is a wonderful, wonderful piece of art. Where you can adjust all of these things and it's interactive. Oh, hey, Equanimous Prime. Lovely to see you. You may have to enable your camera, but he's here. And then we can interact with this piece in real time together in collective consciousness. You can always pop out this little events tab here, this information tab, which will tell you about the artist. Boom, 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 boom.
Wow, Peach. Oh my goodness.
There it is.
Thank you. Can everybody please just give a round of applause for Miss Peach Melba? Thank you.
Thank you so much.
Thank you so much. I think now that we know how to use the Sparkleverse, we need to get our minds ready for the Sparkleverse. So does anybody know what these 10 principles people keep talking about are? I don't know. Sparkle Bobcat, do you know? Oh, yes. Please tell us.
I do. In fact, I totally do. In fact, all of you are beginning to get very principled. Why is it so difficult to look away from your screen? I got to tell you guys, Burning Man is not a place. Burning Man is not a festival. Burning Man is not anything more or less than a uniting community, a culture. And the culture is based around these principles, which help us create a world, help us create a community where everybody's seen, heard, shared, accepted, and safe. So I'll turn this back off here. Let us head out to the playa. I want to share with you the 10 principles of Burning Man. This, if you agree to this, you can hold up your scout. I don't know how you would hold up your playa number or do this right here, and you shall see what needs to be seen. Back to playing some music. Oh, right here. Here we go. Boom. 10 principles. Can you see that?
Yes.
All right. Brilliant. Turn some music on here. Where do they go? All right. These are not necessarily in order, but think about them. Close your eyes and listen and chew on whether you would like to live in a world where everybody abides and lives by these principles to make their own present moment and the present moment of everybody they come in contact with day in, day out, even in their dreams, a better one. Number one, radical inclusion. Anyone may be a part of Burning Man. That means you. Hold your hand on your chest and realize you can be part of this, wherever you are, whoever you are. We welcome and respect the stranger. There's no strangers anymore. And you know what's good about people who are strangers? They're strange. That's why you should get to know them. Look how fun we are. No prerequisites exist for participation in our community. I think it's missing a why. It is your community. You are part of it. You are included. Number two, gifting. Gifting. Burning Man is devoted to acts of gift giving. In fact, I would say that the entire culture is a giant gift to humanity. The value of a gift is unconditional. Gifting does not contemplate a return or an exchange for something of equal value. Does this make it any better? Can you see that better?
Beautiful.
Can you see that better? Okay, great. Yeah. Wonderful. So basically, don't go around to get, go around to give. Don't be a go-getter at your burn. Be a go-giver. And everybody doing that will make us in a world where the universe literally showers us with blessings. Decommodification. This is a very, very important one. So all you people who are like, oh man, I should really promote my new crotchless underwear. Or, oh man, I have this CBD thing that's really great. Think about this, okay? You're not here to sell. I'm not coming here to be a consumer. I have nothing to sell you, nothing to convince you of. I just want to connect. Decommodification. In order to preserve the spirit of gifting, our community seeks to create social environments that are unmediated by commercial sponsorships, transactions, or advertising. You might meet some people here who are called influencers, but they will not be presenting themselves as influencers. They're humans here to share whatever gift they have. And I hope that you can all come that way as well. We stand ready to protect our culture from such exploitation. Yeah, I know a flaming octopus that'll have some words with you. We resist the substitution of consumption for participatory experience. We'll get to participation. Radical self-reliance. make sure you've got chips. I don't know if you can see me right now, but you're gonna have chips, you have a hat, you gotta have your water bottle, you gotta have a cup that clips onto you with a carabiner. You're not gonna be leaving your room for the next 8 days, okay? Let's be honest. Let's hope you have enough water. Load up the bathtub, get a cup. You gotta be prepared. Radical self-reliance. Burning Man encourages the individual to discover, exercise, and rely on his or her inner resources. I will add that there is Playa Help out there. If you can't find it, go to Playa Help. Cool. Radical self-expression. Radical self-expression arises from the unique gifts of the individual. No one other than the individual or a collaborating group, and this means you and us together, can determine its content. It is offered as a gift to others. In this spirit, the giver should respect the rights and liberties of the recipient. I will say that there is talk about having an 11th Burning Man principle called consent. I think this one goes with consent. If you're offering something as a gift, even if it's a kind of a contact or an intimate gesture, and that gift is not aligned with that moment for the other person, then you need to respect the rights and liberties of the recipient. Think about that. We are going to have some very adult potential situations, and keep that in mind. If they don't want your gift, that's not a problem. Just let them take care of themselves. Communal effort. We are getting there. Our community values creative cooperation and collaboration. We strive to produce, promote, and protect social networks, public spaces, works of art, and methods of communication that support such interaction. If you thought Burning Man was just people getting dressed up for an expensive camping trip in the desert, okay, that is part of it. But we very much want to preserve our culture and have things in our culture that are amazing so we can share them with you. Welcome home. We got to do it together. Civic responsibility. We value civil society, as strange as that sounds. Community members who organize events should assume responsibility for public welfare and endeavor to communicate civic responsibilities to participants. They must also assume responsibility for conducting events in accordance with local, state, and federal laws. International laws even. Although if you're coming into Sparkleverse from international waters on your yacht with Elon Musk, more power to you. You could probably get away with just about anything. Basically, take care of other people as well as yourself. Civic responsibility. Okay, the last three. I'm a big fan of number three. Leave no trace. Our community respects the environment. We are committed to leaving no physical trace of our activities wherever we gather. If you're leaving, you know, bits and bytes and megawatts around on the playa, we will see it and we will come over. We'll hand you a trash bag and you can pick them up. Your mama ain't out here, although my mom might be in this room. Hi, Mom. We clean up after ourselves and endeavor whenever possible to leave such places in a better state than when we found them. So yeah, if you see something on the ground that looks like it might be missing an owner, pick it up, pay it forward, keep everything clean out there. Participation. You are here right now participating. Thank you. That is your gift. I know I'm talking a lot, but we're going to move along real quick. Participating. Our community is committed to a radically participatory ethic. We believe that transformative change, whether in the individual or in society, can occur only through the medium of deeply personal participation. If you came here curious about how we could be transformative, if you could experience something that would actually change your life, where you talk about the story of your life as the part before Sparkleverse and the part after it, like so many of us do, then participate, show up, you get out what you give. Whoops, whoa. We achieve being through doing. Everyone is invited to work. Everyone is invited to play. We make the world real through actions that open the heart. Put your hand up to that camera again one more time. Feel how real this is. Everybody out there is connecting with you. We're on the last one. We're going to do it when? We're going to do it right now. Immediacy. Immediate experience is, in many ways, the most important touchstone of value in our culture, in your culture. We seek to overcome barriers that stand between us and a recognition of our inner selves. Not the person you put on out that you want us to see, the person you are when no one's looking. Share that, and this helps you connect with who that is. The reality of those around us, participation in society, and contact with a natural world exceeding human powers. Think about all the electrons that are flying around this planet just to make this experience you're having happen right now. That's pretty crazy. No idea. No idea can substitute for this experience. You are here with us. Welcome home. I'm Bobcat. We'll see you in the playa. All right, who's next? What's up?
Thank you, Bob.
Some chips. Oh, y'all want some chips? Here, get some chips. You look hungry. Get some chips.
Fantastic.
That was awesome. That was awesome.
Thank you.
So, I am. Hello. I am. No, thank you. I am Miss Frizz. Many people just call me Frizz, and I am so happy to be talking to you about gift giving. And it really isn't gift giving. It's really something that Bobcat started to share, which was Burning Man is devoted to acts of gift giving. And I just realized that I need a better background. So the value of a gift is unconditional. Gifting, and also I'm on fire. So can you already see that, like, I'm kind of in the Burning Man mode here, but this is a little serious. This is a really beautiful strand that runs through all of Burning Man, but the value of a gift is unconditional. Gifting does not contemplate a return or exchange for something of equal value. Since we're unable to be in person, we invite you to consider sharing a gift with those you meet and greet on the playa while you're here this week. And a gift can be a song you love, your favorite poem, sharing a recipe, your favorite book, a photo that you love, whatever. But just imagine that it's something that you value and something that you chose to share digitally with other people. So how you do this can be by putting it in the chat as a direct message to the people that you meet and see. And on the far right of the of your screen, you can see that you can direct message people. So you can literally just like drop a little something in there at any point if you want to. And anyone you meet can send a direct message to you too. And that's where you can drop your gift there. This isn't a must do. Everything is just a suggestion, but I can promise you that if you come bearing gifts, you most certainly will leave with more gifts than you can imagine. And when I say that whatever you think you're experiencing here, if you're picking up our vibes, like, it is totally real. And we are so excited to give to you because we have each received so much more than we could have ever imagined in this past year. So we want to give you your first gift now. And I'm going to put it in the chat to all of you. And it is, first, I'm going to get you hot so that for those of you that have a snap filter or your snap camera, you can look for this. You can look for this and you can be on fire too, like me. And then also so that you don't have to worry about anything that you're wearing, as Iona mentioned, yeah, to go with the pickles, right? As Iona mentioned, or maybe it was Peach Melba, I'm not sure now, but there is a whole wardrobe and costume area. So anyone that is inspired to be different or play different, and I will also give you a special filter here, which is something that one of the wonderful benefits of being virtual is that you will not have to experience this, and you can just experience it digitally. And I'm having one moment of, here we go. So this is a background filter that you can use, and you can be extra grateful that you're not using a port potty, and you're able to experience many of the wonderful benefits of the virtual burn and just have the porta potty be behind you. So enjoy your burn, and with a heartfelt welcome, and enjoy the playa and everything that comes after it and with it.
Yeah. So, thank you for
somebody light a candle or something. Ooh. In here, you guys. Light a candle. Here we go. We can air it out. Open the door. Swing the door a little bit. All right.
Let's light it up, baby. Light it up. Okay, so I think we have some really amazing things that are going to be happening on the fly this week. We've already heard a bunch, but like, I specifically want to hear from a couple of people who are doing insane things. And I know we have this amazing, amazing woman from Australia. I believe her name is Leah Simmons, doing some kaya with us. Leah, looking amazing.
Hello, everybody. How are you all?
So good now that you're here.
Amazing.
Sorry, it's very, very early in the morning here in Australia. but we are so excited to be here. I can't wait to showcase our incredible camp to everybody. We've got a lot of interesting and excellent things going on, but more importantly, I'm just excited to share this space with you guys and get to meet some of you. And this is going to be my first burn, virtual or otherwise. So I'm super excited to be able to experience it in this amazing way. I would really like to, one of the things that we really tap into in Camp Kaya is this whole sense of just gratitude and being grateful for, you know, everything that we have around us, no matter what is going on in the world. How about you guys all just jump onto the chat and just send down the line one thing that you are grateful for today, and let's get that chat lit up. One thing. Pizza, yes. Oh. Why? Absolutely. Dancing, the internet, cookies, music, connectivity, fresh tomatoes. Because, yes, books, giggles, love, wonderful people. Bondi Beach, absolutely. Buffleverse, what a beautiful, yes. Music, love. Well, I just wanted to say good morning, good afternoon, good evening, wherever you are. We are all here together, and thank you so much for having me. And I look forward to experiencing just what this playa is all about. Mwah. Thank you, everybody.
Oh, thank you, Leah. Thank you so much. I have to tell you, I've been doing kaya for the past month and a half, maybe 2 months. Game changer, but also my booty, so tight. So if you want a tight booty, get over to Camp Kaya. Make it happen. Thank you, Leah, for being here. We super appreciate you. Thank you so much. And it looks like we also have a couple of other friends who are going to share about what they're doing. And then we have a dance party. So get ready for it. It looks like Aaron, are you ready to share about some of your Burning Man experiences? Possibly? Maybe? Ooh, hello, Aaron. Welcome. Yes, to you too. Fuck your burn. Fuck everybody's burn. Lovely, Aaron. Tell us what you're here for.
Well, welcome to this sacred space, on the verge of this sacred week. My name is Aaron, also known as Airhorn, also known as the Troll King of the CRC, or the Co-Reality Collective, the controllers of this Sparkleverse. You may see me from time to time in various sessions, trolling whatever is happening. Don't be scared to talk to me. I don't bite hard. This is a universe full of art, theater, dance, dreams, themes, and schemes. Now on the schedule of this ceremony, they have me listed as a high-spirited burner. I guess that's a polite way of putting it. If you ever encounter me and I say something snarky and belittling, I say it out of love. I come here to connect with the world at large. To take the pulse of the people, to get a dose of the 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 dose of
Ooh, that got some next level up in here. Sorry, you're in there.
Aaron, are you trolling me? Get out of here! Stop it! All right, back to you. Aaron, he's going to get you.
Sorry about that, Aaron, but please continue if you can. No, it's on the playa. You just never know when a dust storm is going to arrive, you know? You just never know.
Hey, Aaron, I think you were on mute.
If you ever encounter me and I say something snarky and belittling, I say it out of love. I come here to connect with the world at large. To take the pulse of the people. To get a dose of humanity and to get a sense of what everyone is feeling. So during the week, don't be shy to say hi. Enjoy yourselves and welcome home.
Welcome home, everybody. Welcome, welcome, welcome.
Thank you.
Talk of us.
So it looks like we only have a couple more minutes until our dance party, but we already heard from the Block Art Peruvian crew. They came up. So Camp Afro. Yes, people, what is this? Your first Zoom call? Stop it. So do we have a Afro psychedelic in the house to bring us? Lola, I see you here. Lola.
I'm coming up in 10 minutes.
Lola, do we have you? Maybe not. Maybe hey. Not.
Hey, I'm not here.
Where are you?
I'm coming. I'm trying to set up. Can you give me 5 minutes?
Yes.
Yeah.
You can dance for 5 minutes. Y'all want to dance for 5 minutes? Or someone speak?
But we do have another person, maybe Chris from Blind Burners, if you want to tell us what's going on with you over in your camp. I would love, 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 love to hear that.
Thank you, Bobbly, Sparkly, Perry. Hi, everybody. So Blind Burners is a group of blind, partially sighted, and sighted artists and performers. We met in 2019 on the way to Black Rock City, or we were conceived at that point, and we were born in the Metaverse Burns of last year. In Africa Burn, actually, and then this where we met. Someone told us about these people who were hosting parties in the human body and in a tree, and that turned out to be the Coriolis Collective, and that kind of met what we were looking for. So the great thing about the Playa is that you can touch stuff, and for some of my closest friends who have lost their sight, if you can't touch stuff, it doesn't exist. So we had a blast and loved engaging with artists and climbing stupid stuff, doing stupid things. And then when our beautiful culture moved online, we got obsessed with how that translates. So one thing that we loved about Coreality was the playfulness and the visual aspects. And so we have one rule in our camp, which is that anything of importance that's purely visual gets described or sonified, but as long as in line with like people's preferences. So we have like descriptive dance floors, dance sessions. We kind of play with people and they come into a room to get them to describe themselves. And we got really obsessed with virtual reality, actually, which at the time felt like a hard goal. But we've actually built our first camp in BRCVR. And we tried our best to kind of link Sparkleverse and BRCVR through that. And I think it's a world first. There's about two or three experiments in making virtual reality accessible to visually impaired people, or replicating what that might feel like. And ours is one of them. So we're using corridors of sound to enable people to navigate that world. And we're showing a bunch of art by visually impaired and partially sighted artists. In Sparkleverse, we've got a ton of stuff. It's not plugged in yet. It looks like it's there, but we need Sparkle Engineer Superhero to plug it in. But we've kind of got a good mix of things that represent our interests. We've got performances by London-based queer-esque artist called Lex Electric, who has pioneered kind of really diving into subjective audio description. So, you know, a lot of people who do audio description of mainstream culture, like on the BBC and PBS and stuff, will go quiet when they're confronted with something with our culture or with like a drag screen or something like that. But we kind of like diving into that and translating that to people who can't see. We've got audio described movie drive-in, so like hundreds of audio tracks to movies. We've got a talk by a super researcher we recently connected with who's helping with the VR project, talking about accessibility in video games. We've got SoundCloud, DJs. We've got Poet Marimutu's blog. And in terms of the live events, we're just kind of throwing it together. But on Wednesday night, we've got a really special thing. And I think one of the DJs is here. So our friend Tiger Lily in Montana has put together a night of DJs. I think three or four of the DJs are either blind or partially sighted. It's at, I think it's from 11 o'clock. No, 4 o'clock PST, I think, on Wednesday. And Kevin is here as well. Kevin's like new to our group. They're awesome. I don't know, Kevin, and Kevin's hobbies include reading restaurant menus to people. So if you want your restaurant menu, he knows more about British food than anybody I know.
So much. Yeah. That is fantastic. I'm so sorry. We are running a little bit behind. I do want to bring in one more person, and then we're going to have a mega dance party, and we're going to start this burn. Chris, I cannot wait to check out Blind Burners. Like, seriously, I always love your guys' stuff. Everyone head over to Blind Burners Camp. They have amazing things happening all week long. And so the last person I want to bring up is a Mr. Very, very wonderful Daniel Lismore with Miss Frizz, who is looking fantastic. Hello. Hello.
Hello. Hi. I just want to say a very quick quote. And it was always given to Oscar Wilde, but he never actually said it. And it was from a book about him. It's "Be yourself. Everybody else is already taken." And I think it's one of the most important quotes that we have as a species, because we're so lost. And everyone's so concerned, and everybody is so caught up. And I think when you start to think about yourself, you can think about everybody else just afterwards. So be you, and then think about everybody else. And I think it's the most beautiful thing that you can do. Just try and, you know, it's not about discovery. It's about finding who you are. And you can spend so much time looking for something that's already in you. You've already got it. You know, what is the journey for? Like, you're already there. You are you. You can't help that. And that is the most important thing that I've ever learned in my life. So I just wanted to put that over and sending lots of love. And burn, burn, burn.
Burn, 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 baby. Burn, burn, burn. Thank you so much, Daniel. That is absolutely beautiful. Everybody, please check out Miss Alternative Universe. They have been going hard for years and years and years, and they are co-creating this insane, amazing Sparkleverse burn with us. So we do have, I lied. I'm so sorry, y'all. We have one more person before we go into our dance party, which is Daniel and Avishta. So I'd love for you to come on up and talk about everything that you have planned with your amazing camp for Camp Languages. And then we're going to have a real dance party. So Avishta, I'm trying to spot you, but it doesn't look like it's possible. Richard Simcoe.
I'm going to leave, you know, and just like blame it on my bad internet.
Oh, Frizz, do you have bad internet? I think so, maybe. Let's mute you.
Hot mic,
baby. Hot.
That's like part of the jokes that like we're supposed to put in to make it funny. You know what I mean? So now. That was like, did you hear that on purpose?
It was on purpose, and I'm so glad it was. Avishta, let us know what's going on with Camp Languages, and we'll end out with an amazing dance party.
Sure. Hello, everybody. My name is Avishta. Actually, Richard and I work, we've organized Camp Languages together, which is new to Sparkleverse this year. I know we're running short of time, so I'm just going to highlight a few sessions very quickly. So we've got three main rooms, language learning, language exchange, and language culture experience. And there's also a recording of a session called Learning a New Language or Culture Without Losing Yourself, which is really cool. It's a recording, so you can go see it at any time. Some sessions that are really cool that will be happening throughout the week are our translanguaging sessions, where people will be using several languages in one session. So one person will start a conversation in one language, another person will respond in a different language. And normally we do that by language families, and the most popular ones are the Slavic, the Romance language families, and the Nordic ones or Germanic ones. So we have sessions like that happening. Also, if you're learning a language right now, you would like to practice one, chances are we do have a language session happening. So do check out our language exchange room. There's quite a few going on there, French, Portuguese, Spanish, lots of them. And the last one is the language and culture experience. Some sessions that Iona mentioned earlier are that are pretty cool are our dance sessions. We have a salsa and a bachata session happening on Thursday and Friday. And we've got some cooking sessions as well. There's going to be a girl from Sweden, and she'll be teaching us how to make meatballs. And there's going to be some storytelling and some Jamaican music and some folklore. Lots and lots going on. So do check out Camp Languages. And our very first session started today, and it'll be going on all throughout the week. That's it. Thank you.
Oh, thank you so much, Avisha and Richard. You all have amazing programming. I cannot wait to see all of it. So I lied again, and I'm so sorry for it. But hey, you got to have your plan, and then you got to burn it, baby. Burn that plan. I do want to bring up Lola one more time, and now we're going to dance, and we're just building up that hype. So Lola, please, I would love to hear all about Camp Afro-Psychedelic from Blueberries. Tell us all about it.
Darling, darling, from fruit to fruit, you're muted.
Muted.
Hi.
I think you brought out the wrong word, Lola. Bring up Hola Hida.
This is an amazing experience. This is our first Sparkleverse. I actually did Burn 10 years ago, I made the best friends in the world. The art was amazing, and I am so glad to be here today and to hear about all of this and to see all of you. Hi.
Hi, fantastic. I'm so sorry. It looks like we might have a couple of Lolas in the room, a couple of Lolas. So Lola, darling, and Captain Cook, you are more than welcome to spotlight our lovely, lovely Lola from Afro Psychedelic, if you can find her. But it looks like our Blueberries Lolas were not the same Lolas, the Afro Psychedelic Lolas.
I was wondering that.
It's okay, baby. Just burn that plan. Just burn that plan. Hello. Welcome. Tell us about Afro Psychedelic. Welcome. Welcome.
So much. Glad to be here. Sorry it took so long. So Afro Psychedelic is actually a combination of different arts groups in Nigeria. We have a bunch of dance groups, a bunch of singers. We have magicians.
Oh no, darling, yeah. I'm muted. You just keep on going, we'll handle it.
All right, so we have...
Oh no, darling, it looks like you are muted. You can unmute yourself then.
Okay, there. So Afro Psychedelic is a...
I'm so sorry, Lola. There are people coming into the room. I keep trying on muting them, and then it's just popping up. Thank you for dealing with the technology. Continue.
So yeah, Afro Psychedelic is extremely excited to bring in the African experience, to bring in the African dance, the music, the vibe, the culture, and everything to the Burn. From our team has actually never been to Burning Man Festival, and this is going to be our first experience, and it's already been so wonderful and warm, and collective, and it's so amazing to feed off everybody's energy. Even if it hasn't started already, it's just so amazing, and I'm really, really glad to be here. I can't wait for everything to start and for us to be able to share our experience with you and to take part in your experiences, basically. It's been amazing.
Thank you, Lola. I appreciate you. Thank you so much for being here. Camp Everest Psychedelic has 43 performers and musicians and magicians. It's going to be lit. Thank you so much for being here. And it looks
there's a performance next, isn't there, Lola, in your camp? So if anybody wants to go on over there.
Hello, we have a dance performance going on for an hour, 30 minutes.
Yes, you do. Yes, you do. Oh, I cannot wait. I cannot wait. And you know what we're having right now? We're having a dance performance featuring...
Okay, sorry to hijack again. But I have to mention I am going to be screening a documentary all about me in life Tuesday at 8 p.m. CST, 6 p.m. PST, and 6 p.m. CST, 4 PST, ST on Saturday, and both screenings are on the Co-Reality main stage. Gotta run, see you on the playa.
On the playa, Aaron. There you go, everybody. Now you know when that is happening. There's so much happening, so much happening. And you know what's happening right now? We're dancing. And Jess Dance is on here. Let's go, Jess Dance. Let's go.
Hey. What's up, guys? Can you hear me? Can you guys give me a thumbs up if you guys can hear me loud and clear? Awesome. What's up, Sparkleverse? What's up, Party Man? My name is DJ Jess Dance. I am part of the creator of the Days Discoteca Camp. So come check us out. We're going to be DJing and playing music all throughout this week. There'll be me and a bunch of other DJs. So I'm very, very excited. But let's have some fun and dance, because that's all I really like to do anyways, because it just makes everything better. So let's get to the tunes. Thank you so much for having me. Let's go. guys. I hope you're having so much fun. Thank you so much.
Burn, burn.
Spread love. Supposed to go, so someone's gonna have to let me know. What's up, Sparklers? Welcome to the Burn. Everyone knows this one. You gotta sing along. We'll be right back.
in the air if you could hear the music. So good to see all your faces here on Zoom. What's up? Welcome to the Burn. Party without a llama. We got llamas. The one-eyed gypsy. What's up? Yes. Dogs, blueberries, llamas, and more. I love it.
sounds better with you, Sparkleverse. Welcome to the Burn. Thank you so much for having me. My name is DJ Just Dance, aka Chaos. Raining where I'm at in the desert. Monsoon season.
Disco, make it go super like Cisco. Disco, make it go super like Cisco. Disco.
you're hot and sweaty. Welcome to the Burn. Thank you so much for hanging out with me and everyone here. It's so good to see your faces.
We want
to
go back
and blueberries.
this is when you really feel good sometimes. You be good to me, I'll be good to you.
Are feeling the tunes, I'll be back again at 7 p.m. Pacific Standard Time for Night Rhythm. You can catch me at the Dazed Discoteca camp, and I'll be hanging out all week, so I'd love to meet a lot of you and check out all the other camps. Thank you so much for tuning in and hanging out. Sending you so much love. Thanks for dancing with me and hanging out. We'll be right back.
Let's let the sunshine in. For joining. My name is DJ Just Dance, aka Kazka, coming to you from the Days Discoteca camp. I can't wait to see you guys more throughout the week. It's been my pleasure. It's amazing. Party train going to keep the tunes alive and the groove going. Thank you guys so much. I'll see you guys
throughout the day. I'll be on again at 7 p.m., but I'll be hanging out at different parties and whatnot and in the Sparkleverse. I can't wait to meet you guys. Thank you so much. I'm not sure if anyone from Sparkleverse is here or if wanted to say something or if it's okay to just go. I don't know because I can't hear anyone. But either way, thank you guys so much. Sending you so much love. Welcome to the Burn, and I can't wait to meet all of you. Feel free to follow me anywhere, and I can't wait to keep in touch with you guys. It's so good to see you guys. Thank you, thank you, thank you. Yes. I guess we're going to these links. Let's keep it going. The music, or are you just talking about to the another party? Well, yes, the music's going to keep going, but we're going to a different camp, correct? I think that's what's happening. I think that's
thank you so much.
Thank you. Thank you. I had so much fun.
Let's give it up for Jen.
I've hijacked the sparkle.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. I love your outfit.
I love your existence, Daniel Lismore. I love it. I love
yes,
it. I love
all of it.
I love it.
Never been told that by a cherry before. Or are you a peach?
I was a peach.
A peach.
This has been a fantastic, fantastic, fantastic gate party and opening ceremony. We are going to keep it going. So please, please, please go to the Camp Co-Reality Soundstage. Go to the long party, hear some Leonardo da Vinci, but also guess what? There's a Kaya workout going on. There's some Afro psychedelic shit going on. All the shit's going down. So enjoy Sparkleverse. We're gonna be happening for a week. We're gonna be here. Come hang out, come enjoy. Much love, welcome home.
Welcome home.
Are you rid of us?
just hanging out.
Just all chilling with a creepy Zordon head. Oh, humans. Quiet humans in chat. Thanks. They're headphones. Whoosh. Yeah. You want to hear a song? I could play a song in my little ocarina. Just close my eyes and pretend I'm at the Renaissance Fair. It's a little hobbit song. I think that's how it goes. I'm not sure. I don't read music. I just try to play music. Thanks. I have a chicken, but she's outside. She did some tricks earlier. The party moved to another room. The parties I see are like mostly dancing. That gets really tiring after a while. This is hot. At least it's hot where I am. But it's good to find other humans that are humans and not art pieces. Let's see. What do we got going on here? We're live. There's a Pearl's Place thing, but that's like the tiny chat rooms. So I don't know. I went to the like Talk to God place, and that place was pretty all right. But I haven't found like many other rooms with like humans hanging out. Looking at the list of things, it's hard to tell what's a room and what's like an art project. Yeah, I had my chicken do tricks for him and we talked. She can spin and she can jump. And then I was just like, thanks for the chicken. Every time I ever tried to talk to God on the playa, no one was there. So that was cool. That's some awesome hair. You're like a Van de Graaff generator.
Hi.
I love your wig.
Thank you. Fabulous. All right. I am just, I'm saying hello and hello. Goodbye.
You're like Einstein's spunky younger sister.
Thank you. I'll take that. And I like it. So thank you for that. And I will look forward to seeing you again on the playa, Jesse. I'll be here all week.
Have fun.
Bye.